Let me show you a quick but delicious way of marinating lamb chops. Simple ingredients you need to have on your possession or on your hand. Black pepper, white pepper, French thyme or any kind of thyme will work. Any aromatic herb you prefer, mint will work as well. I have some sage, it's fresh. You can have dry sage. I have some sumach. It's a tangy, beautiful spice that goes perfect with meat. That's my opinion. Cayenne, if you like it hot, you don't like it hot, remove the cayenne. Some olive oil, onion. And if you notice, I have no salt. The salt will be added while it's roasting or grilling or frying. It's just a marinade recipe. So, but we'll be doing barbecue tonight. That's why we'll be barbecuing the lamb chops. First, we need to separate them from each other. Let's do this. I'm not a big meat expert. I think I can do this. Okay, I did it perfectly. Actually, I'm a meat expert now. I did the second one incredibly perfectly. How fine they are. You just find this middle part, the soft part, and carefully cut through. Let me finish and we'll go from there. After successful separation of lamb chops from each other, we make the marinade. The marinade or the dressing is pretty simple. About 2 to 3 tablespoons of olive oil, and it's pretty greasy itself, but it still does need some of the olive oil texture, taste, and everything. And I'm going to probably finely chop my sage. It's only a small amount, and you don't need a lot because sage is pretty strong. I'm gonna make it as small as possible. Everything goes into olive oil. And normally I eyeball it, but I'll give you not precise measurements. So I'll add probably a teaspoonful of sumach, just like so. I'll add a good pinch of thyme, like this. I'm gonna almost squeeze it. Just like so. White pepper, half a teaspoonful. Black pepper, a teaspoonful. Freshly ground is much better. This may take a while. Cayenne to taste, you like it spicy. Add, let's say, a full teaspoon. You don't like it spicy? With a tip of teaspoon, like quarter or third of a teaspoon. Did I add everything? Yes. I'm gonna give this a quick stir. If you have some paprika, we don't have paprika, it's a good idea to add it as well. Now, we need some onion. The meat will be resting between layers of onion. Let me get this. It's pretty large, I'm not gonna use the whole thing. Make it thin or thick, just as it goes. So I'm gonna grab my thyme. Actually, it's a good idea to do this in a Ziploc. It's even better. But I already grab a pan, so I'll go with the pan. A thin layer of onion, just like so. You wanna cover the entire pan. You want each single piece to touch the onion. All right, So what we do, we grab our brush, brush on one side, generously, place it on your onion and brush it again and continue until done. You want to cover it completely. It's going to be so flavorful. We're done. I mean, we're not done yet. We're just done with brushing the marinade over the lamb chops. And you don't want to waste all this good stuff. Go ahead and finish it. And top layer, onions. And I'm going, since we're doing it today, I'm not going to put this into a fridge. You know, meat has to be room temperature, whether you're cooking, frying, or roasting, so I'm gonna leave it at room temperature about an hour or so, and it should be enough. Even better if it's 2 hours. A few more slices, and I also want to show you my creamy dressing that goes with lamb chops. Okay, almost done. I don't want to cut too much onions. And I did cut too much onions. So I'm going to wrap this in plastic and set it aside. I'm gonna give it a quick squeeze so they get to know each other.
Papa!
This is done. Papa is working. Papa, where is plus screwdriver? Look in the garage, my boy.
It's not there in the garage.
For the creamy dressing, you can either get strand yogurt or even regular yogurt. But creamiest is either creme fraiche or sour cream. So I have sour cream. I'll probably add about 2 good tablespoons of sour cream. Add more or less. This is something you do or make to taste. Let's say I have 2 good ice cream scoops. And then either use fresh garlic or get regular garlic stems. This is from my garden. I think they are very fragrant and flavorful and even better than garlic itself. Because they're very tender and mild on taste, not super garlicky. In goes the garlic or garlic stems. Also, if you like it spicy, and you do like it spicy, well, if you don't like it, remove the seeds. And I'm doing just like that. I'm removing the seeds because it's super spicy. Jalapeno peppers, finely crushed. Also, we'll need lemon zest and juice, a dash of cumin, black pepper is a good idea, and some salt. Yeah, also the juice from lemon. I don't know if I mentioned it. Okay, teeny weeny. And the pepper joins this mixture. Zest of lemon, finely zested. And I'll probably use half of the lemon. You do want to break this creaminess and sweetness of sour cream, sweetness of sour cream with some tanginess from lemon. And half a lemon. And it's also a lemon juicer, so you don't get any seeds. I think I'm done. A dash of cumin, a little bit more. Black pepper and salt to taste. Just like so. Beautiful sea salt. quick mix. And the sauce or dressing for lamb chops is ready. You can save it in the fridge. Takinche-san, what is he doing?
Getting
lots of cookies. Oh, you want cookies? I get it. It's hard to reach. It's hard to reach. With snowman. Okay, they made some Christmas cookies today. Okay, enjoy.
Is it yours?
Quick test. It's asking for more lemon. It needs the tanginess, more tanginess. Mm-hmm. And that's it, this is ready. I'm gonna set this in the fridge, and when the time comes, I'll serve it with lamb chops. Time to grill these delicious pieces. They are fully and completely marinated. They took their time, about 3 hours now, I should say. And as you would expect, directly to the grill.
Why are you doing someone done that?
I'm not a big expert when it comes to grilling. Yeah. I said it, but I'm an expert to enjoy grilled food. I know how it is supposed to taste. Yay, smells so good. And this is the time when you start salting, and it's not a good idea to place it on a high fire because the oil from meat can aggregate the fire. You don't want that. Basically, this is such a tender and ready meat, you don't want to overcook it. It's done. I'll put this. Oh, this is ready. Where's the plate?
I am hungry now.
You're hungry? Of course you're hungry. We have a hungry customers waiting for their barbecue.
Our barbecue,
yes. Okay. It's ready, we don't want to burn them.
Yeah.
They basically cook on the fire.
If we burn them, it will taste awful.
Yes, you don't want awful tasting meat. I'll let this a few minutes, not this one. And this is ready. This one a couple of seconds, because this was a pretty thick slice, can you see? A few seconds. Done with our photo session. And yes, I couldn't wait and tried a slice. A small piece. It was amazing. The meat was simply melting. So delicious, so tender. And you want to try it with the sauce? Just like so. So delicious. Super moist, juicy, and even the fat from meat. And we're having a family get together, so it's always noisy in our house. But most importantly, I had a time to share how to marinate incredibly tender, moist lamb chops. Try it, let me know how you liked it. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon. And I'm gonna eat this very soon.